Hello students and welcome back to BankExamsToday.com, and today I'm going to answer one of the really important questions related to RBI Grade B. What to study and how to study, right? So let's start with the finance and management paper. Last year there were a lot of questions from RBI's official website. So if you ask me, sir, what is the best source of information or what is the best study material for finance section in the finance and management paper, there is finance. For the finance section, it is RBI's official website and SEBI's official website. That's the most reliable source of information, source of study material as well, you can say, right? So RBI's official circulars and master circulars. On RBI's website, you will find notifications, master circulars, and then FAQs, frequently asked questions. Frequently asked questions are kind of static topics which are important as well. And then there are notifications, and then there are master circulars. You need to be little choosy, right? When it comes to master circulars, you need to decide whether this particular topic is related to the RBI Grade B syllabus or not. Even in case of notifications, you need to decide. Otherwise, it's a sea of information, right? So in recent past, there are notifications regarding priority sector lending. The small finance banks, now they need to, you know, allot 75% of their lending towards the priority sector. So that was a notification. Then there was a notification regarding RTGS. RTGS, the time window was extended. And then there was a notification regarding NBFCs. And there were some master circulars as well. Really important. That's how you need to study from the RBI's official website. You can allot like 7 to 8 days to the FAQs, frequently asked questions, really important static topics. Then on the regular basis, you need to study the master circulars and the notifications. Why we recommend preparation of at least 8 to 10 months for RBI Grade B? Because it's actually really difficult to study old master circulars. If I tell you that you need to study last 1 year's master circulars and notification, it will take a lot of time, right? So if you are reading it regularly, that will be easy on you, right? So if you just have started your preparation for 2020 exam, and we have also started a proper course for the RBI Grade B 2020, in which we are doing the analysis of RBI, SEBI and everything, whatever I'm going to list down, start from today, right? Start from today. Okay, so every day I'm doing the analysis. This is the source of my information. If you ask me, sir, which kind of teaching material that I am following official RBI website. And then there is latest circulars by SEBI. In the last 1 month, there is a latest circular regarding the DVR, differential voting rights. And then the CSR, corporate social responsibility. CSR, if a company is not... is violating the CSR norms, it was a criminal offense in last 3-4 months, but now the government just scrapped it. So these are the latest circulars in last 1 month. If you are preparing for RBI Grade B, you need to prepare for next 8 to 10 months, right? So there will be at least, you can say, 70 to 80 circulars from SEBI and around 150 to 160 circulars from RBI that you need to follow. Even while going through the notifications and the circulars of RBI, see, whenever I read a notification of RBI, they refer the old notifications. For example, while updating or while giving a notification in that priority sector lending, they'll give a link to the priority sector lending page. Go through it. So while you are reading on 50 notifications, you need to read the old content as well. Okay. So that's really important. So that's how you need to use the official website. That's how we use it. We analyze it, we teach it. Then the any notification or circular by the government of India, any kind of document by the government of India, the Union Budget and Economic Survey is a sort of material that is really important, that we follow personally. Always follow the official and original source of information. Whenever you follow a newspaper, for example, if you're reading a circular from a newspaper, they filter the information. I mean, that is for a common man who's not going to appear for the exam. The newspaper is not going to complicate it, right? The newspapers are actually made for general people, not for students like you, okay? So that's the kind of study material that we are following. And there is static material. In case of numericals, for example, there is ratio analysis, capital budgeting and all. The trend is like few questions are asked from such kind of topics like ratio analysis and all. If you're already reading the official websites and all, you'll come across a lot of topics from ratio analysis and capital budgeting. So anyhow, if you're reading the notifications, you need a basic understanding of ratio analysis, capital budgeting, cost of capital, right? You need a basic understanding. So the concepts like ADR, GDR, interest rate swaps, or derivatives, or like call option, put option, you need a basic understanding of that. Even to understand the notifications, you need a basic understanding. So that's really important. So that's the kind of study material that we are following. I used to recommend the Prasanna Chandra's book. Trust me, it's really difficult. And it is not updated properly. And it's a huge book. In the exam, you'll be finding just 5 or 6 questions from that particular book. So I do not personally recommend that book as of the moment. What I recommend, RBI's official website, SEBI's official website, any document released by the Ministry of Finance, Union Budget, Economic Survey, these are the kind of important study material. Any new bill that is related to the financial markets, for example, the Consumer Protection Bill, that's really important. Okay. Then for ESI, economic and social issues. See, students, the government schemes are really important. The most important part is the government schemes. Schemes for poverty alleviation, for rural employment. A lot of schemes are there. In a year, there will be, there are around 300 or 400 odd active government schemes, out of which I think 60, 70 are really important. So, we maintain a proper list of government schemes, also available on BankExamsToday.com. But from which kind of schemes the questions are asked, that is an important question right now. Important question ye abhi hai. See, whatever is in the news, jo bhi news mein hai, you will find the questions from that particular scheme. Right? Whatever is there in the news, you will find a lot of questions from that particular scheme. Right? So that's for sure. If Mudra scheme is in the news, you'll find the questions. For example, in case of Jandhan Yojana, the overdraft limit was increased, or the age of overdraft limit to avail the overdraft facility was increased, right? So you'll find that particular question in the exam. So ye for sure hai, right? Agar, see, in case there is a scheme which is not updated, there is no news about that particular scheme in last 4, 5 years, 3 years, you are not going to find question from that particular scheme, right? So, then the international reports are important. HDI report, ease of doing business report and all, really, really important. Then committees are again really important. The committees that are in the news. Right now, the UK Sinha committee, the Bimal Jalan committee are really important committee set up by any committee set up by the RBI or SEBI or Ministry of Finance. Really important, right? And latest acts and the bills. I already gave you the example, Consumer Protection Bill or any other new bill. there can be questions regarding the GST. So it can actually happen that there can be a question from government scheme in the finance, and there can be a question from finance in the ESI paper. That's quite common. What about the management? Management is quite static. We follow L.M. Prasad's book. For principles of management, we follow the L.M. Prasad's book. But you can't be sure that all the questions will be there in the L.M. Prasad's book. You cannot be sure. And it is sort of difficult to go through the L.M. Prasad's book. It's a huge book again. But if you can read it, that's the best thing that you can do actually. It'll improve your scores for sure. Okay. That's for the ESI. Seems kind of easy, but not so easy, because you need to keep an eye on the RBI's website, SEBI's website. You need to keep an eye on the newspaper. See, newspaper actually notifies you that this thing is important for you. Why we read the newspapers? They tells us that, see, the DVR is in the news. Find its source of information and then teach it. So that's why we read the newspapers. Newspapers actually notifies us. Okay. I told you about management, finance, and then ESI. In the descriptive paper, find someone who can actually check your questions, tell you your mistakes, right? If you're not practicing, writing, if you're not used to write on paper as well, then it would be difficult. It would be a new experience at the time of exam. You should have an experience of writing. You can actually send me your writings, or you can find somebody to check your essay, right? That's what it's all about, descriptive paper. If you're already reading the notifications, if you're reading newspaper, if you're reading everything, I don't think there will be a problem in the content part, right? Because while writing, there should be some ideas in your mind. And if you're reading, already reading so much, that won't be an issue. Ye issue hoga nahi for the descriptive paper. But anyway, practice is important for descriptive paper. Let's come to the phase one now. For the general awareness, whatever you have done in the finance and the ESI paper, that will help you here. Other than that, the appointments, awards and honors, sports, military exercise, MOUs, whatever is there in the news, and the newspapers are going to help you here, right? It is little different from IBPS PO level exams, because there will be questions from banking and the financial industry. So whatever you have done for the phase two, that will help you here, right? We make RBI Grade B GK Digest. Please follow it. So that's what it's about. So what kind of sources of information I already told you? RBI's official website, the SEBI's official website, the Ministry of Finance, and the Kurukshetra and the Yojana magazines are really important. Newspapers are really important because they notifies you. And then the RBI Grade B GK Digest, we summarize everything, right? So let's move forward. Let's move forward to the quantitative aptitude. See, students, you need to do basic practice of data interpretation, time and work, time and distance, quadratic equations, simple and compound interest. The basic topics you need to do the practice. We provide the practice questions on bankexamstoday.com. You can follow any other website. There are a lot of quality questions available online. Then for the reasoning ability, there are puzzles, seating arrangement, statements and assumptions, blood relations, direction sense test, problem based on edges. Again, a lot of questions are there available online on a lot of websites, and I teach these two subjects personally. Quantitative aptitude, I'm teaching quantitative aptitude from last 7 years. So I wrote a book, Quantitative Aptitude Made Easy. You can find a lot of my lectures available for free on youtube.com as well. So for the English language, if you're already reading a lot, I don't think English will be a problem for you. English section won't be a problem. Even if you are not preparing properly, just do the practice, just solve 5 mock tests, that's it for English language. Nothing else is required according to me. So the team Bank Exams Today, we are providing we have actually started the RBI Grade B 2020 course, and we are doing the complete analysis for you. Complete analysis. We are analyzing the RBI, SEBI's website, RBI's website. We are analyzing the PIBs, Yojana, Kurukshetra. We are doing everything for you, right? And we have just started the RBI Grade B course like 1 week back, right? And you can ask any doubt. In that course, you can just WhatsApp me. I'll provide my WhatsApp number. That is 906720100. And that's a long 1 year course. So if you are ready to give next 1 year to me for this RBI Grade B preparation, this course is for you. If you are interested in a long-term preparation for RBI Grade B, this course is for you. So just install the Bank Exams Today's mobile application and take a demo. Okay. And please subscribe the channel and like this video. That's really important for me. Okay. So thank you and have a very nice day.